The North American International Auto Show is what everybody calls the Detroit Auto Show. And it's the kickoff for automotive season. This year for 2015, the Auto by Tel is gonna take you through some of the cars that are really interesting to see. There's hundreds of new ones here, and these are the ones that we think are worth taking a look at.
Been waiting and waiting and waiting, but it's finally here. The 2016 Acura NSX in full production form. It looks a lot like the concept that we've been seeing for the last 3 years, but there's also a lot to like about it in terms of styling. It's got familiar elements from the original NSX on the hood and in the back in terms of aero. It's got 550 horsepower, roughly, from not one, not two, but three electric engines combined with a longitudinally mounted twin turbo 3.5-liter V6. It's an all-wheel drive car as well. Full EV mode if you want it, and if you don't want it, just step on the gas and you're going to be zipping to 60 probably in less than 3 seconds. That's our prediction anyway.
In the Ford booth at the 2015 Detroit Auto Show, the surprise of the century. We knew they were coming out with a trio of performance options, but we didn't expect the new Ford GT. Not quite as retro as we were hoping, not quite as retro as we were expecting, to be honest with you. Over 600 horsepower, 3.5-liter EcoBoost, carbon fiber everywhere, and just one of the craziest designs you've ever seen in your entire life. And yes, they say it's coming to production next year.
Generally, the mantra at auto shows is look but don't touch, but I'm having a very hard time keeping my hands off of this, the 2016 Cadillac CTS-V. It's a 640 horsepower supercharged rocket that is the best thing this side of a Corvette. What you have here is a 200 mile per hour capable sedan. That's a speed that's faster than any of us could really ever dream of going on the roads in North America. It's the ultimate expression of Cadillac performance. It debuts here following the debut of the ATS-V and the ATS-V Coupe in Los Angeles, and is going to be the next part of Cadillac's move toward performance cars. What we have is a beautiful example in this excellent white finish, hood scoop that's functional, carbon fiber everywhere, beautiful Recaro seats inside, and it's just gorgeous. We can't wait to drive it.
Everything we loved about the RCF is here in the GSF, except this time we get two more doors, packing the 5-liter V8, taking on brands like the BMW M5, Audi RS6, and the new Cadillac CTS-V. We can't wait to get behind the wheel.
One of the most stunning unveils this year in Detroit didn't even happen at the show, and that's the Buick Avenir concept. Avenir, which means future in French, gives us a look at what the future of Buick's flagship LaCrosse sedan could look like. I'd stake money on this car not being built or ever even coming into production in its current form, but the cues that you see behind me are absolutely breathtaking in person. And if the LaCrosse looks even half as good as the sedan, then Buick's stunning turnaround of the last few years is going to be even more incredible. They sold 1.2 million cars globally last year, with the vast majority of those occurring in China. And it's in large part because of the minds that are putting together vehicles like this, vehicles that we haven't seen from Buick in decades.
So you want a 911, but you don't want a convertible? You want it to look a little bit wider in the back? You want it to go a little bit faster? Well, Porsche's got the new Targa GTS just for you. GTS treatment, more power, wider ass, just more badass in general. Targa top, best of both worlds. You don't have to deal with a convertible, you get to have the wind in your hair when you want it. It's really the best of both worlds.
The Alfa Romeo 4C Spider takes everything we liked about the Alfa Romeo Coupe, including the mid-mounted four-cylinder turbocharged engine, the lack of power steering, the carbon fiber tub, and chops off the roof. So now Shaq can buy one and probably comfortably fit. But more importantly, it continues that tradition of open-top motoring that has always been an important part of the Alfa Romeo brand image. And it's yet another reason to be happy that this Italian mark is back on US soil.
The Infiniti G37 was always a crowd pleaser and everybody loved it. And the new iteration of that is going to be called the Q60. This is the new concept version of that car that'll be coming out next year. It's a luxury sports coupe, and of all the concepts at this show, this has to be one of the prettiest.
BMW has brought out the all-new 6 Series. That's a sport, coupe, oversized, luxury, opulent speed machine. Now on top of that, we have the M6. Powered by a twin-turbo V8, the M6 is sure not to disappoint.
For 2016, Chevy has redesigned the Volt from the ground up and created a whole new look for itself. It's a really good looking car. But in addition to that, they've gone and designed a fully electric concept called the Bolt, not to be confused with the Volt. The Bolt is expected to have a range of about 200 miles and cost about $30,000. It's kind of a compact crossover style, and it's pretty interesting looking.
What's the only thing better than walking through the Detroit Auto Show? Well, it's this, the Honda Unicub. This is, it takes an hour and a half to charge, runs for an hour and a half on a battery, and it's totally seamless based on your body motions. You, as I try to turn around here to center myself, you have to lean in, and it takes a little bit of balance to get right, but it's almost as easy as walking. Using kind of the same motions you would have on a motorcycle, you've got foot pedals, and I'm almost centered here. It's meant for a more petite person, but they're working apparently on a bigger one that can accommodate a more substantial American. What's really interesting about it is you have these foot pedals here, if you work, and it straightens itself out based on how your body works. To move forward, lean forward. To straighten out, reverse thrust, you lean back. And it moves as quickly as your body does, reacting with a reflex that is robotic. It's part of Honda's commitment to robots that we've seen in Osimo and this robot-like Unicub. It pays homage to the motorcycle heritage that Honda has. It's not very fast. You can ride it around a pretty flat, dry plain, and we're interested to take it out for a spin and see how it goes.
Volkswagen fans might remember the Cross Blue concept. That was a very large seven-seater SUV with a very green drivetrain underneath it. Now, what we have behind us at the 2015 Detroit Auto Show is the Cross Coupe concept. Now, this takes everything great about the Cross Blue, shrinks it down to a 5-passenger package, which is based on a plug-in hybrid powertrain that offers all-wheel drive.
Ready to be confused? There are two versions of the all-new Mercedes-Benz GLE Class Coupe. This one, the 577 horsepower Mercedes-AMG GLE 63S, and then one over my shoulder, which is the Mercedes-Benz 450 AMG 4MATIC. Kind of hard to keep them apart, but they both have 4MATIC all-wheel drive, 7-speed automatic transmission, and a curved sloping roofline that's intended to give it the style needed to compete against vehicles like the BMW X6 and the BMW X6M.
This is the 2015 Volvo S60 Cross Country. It's Volvo's answer to the question, what do I do if I want four-wheel drive, a little bit of ride height, but I don't want a crossover? Now, Volvo sells a really attractive crossover coming up called the XC90, but for some people, that's gonna be a little bit too big. What we have here is the S60. This is Volvo's midsize sedan that's been raised 2.6 inches. Really not a lot of ground clearance at all, but it's enough to give the car a little bit of a raised appearance. Similar tactics have been tried out on the Subaru SUS, which is a legacy sedan that eventually became the Outback. It's not quite as tall as an AMC Eagle, for those of us who remember that car, and it's done a lot more tastefully.
Audi's been trying out some new things, including the A3 compact sedan. The latest addition is the Q3 compact crossover. Now, this is a really hot emerging market. It's considered to be a premium compact crossover. It's a four-door with a hatchback, and it's one of my favorite things to see at this show.
Suddenly, it seems like everybody needs to have a mid-sized truck. And hot on the heels of the all-new Colorado and Canyon from General Motors, we have a refreshed 2016 Toyota Tacoma. I hesitate to call this a complete redesign. It's got a carryover four-cylinder motor, but a new 3.5-liter V6. We don't know how much horsepower, but it runs on the Atkinson cycle, so it's intended to have better fuel efficiency than before. And we got 6-speed automatic transmissions across the board with a 6-speed manual for the V6. Styling has been updated. The chassis has been stiffened. You can still get the TRD off-road version of this truck. It's going to be interesting to see if Toyota can maintain its near-death grip on the midsize sales lead that it's had for, I don't know, almost a decade. But if they're going to do it, this is the weapon they're going to do it with.
The vehicle on my left is not the new Ford F-150 pickup. Instead, this is Nissan's Titan. It's brand new for 2016. It is larger, as you can tell, than any pickup that Nissan has ever done before. Although, from what I've heard, it actually fits in the same shadow as the pickup that it replaces. The first model that's going to launch is the Titan XD, which is a diesel-powered model. From that point forward, there will be conventional models with smaller body and longer bed lengths. We're really interested in this car because of what it represents for Nissan. It's going to be built in the Canton, Mississippi factory, and I don't think I'll be able to put one on the street in Brooklyn because my street isn't this wide.
Concepts are supposed to be weird, but more to the point, concepts are supposed to get us talking about ideas that maybe aren't already out on the market. And the Santa Cruz crossover truck concept certainly does a good job about that. Instead of saying, hey, why don't we take a big truck and shrink it down to a smaller size, they said, why don't we take a crossover and put something like a pickup bed on it? That way you get the practicality combined with the comfort of a daily driver like a crossover already gives you. It's a really interesting idea. You have a pull-out bed in the back for when you need to haul extra stuff that doesn't quite fit. And it's based on existing Hyundai architecture, which means that this thing is almost production ready. Maybe not the styling, but everything underneath could roll out of an assembly line in the near future.
Now for a car that you can't actually buy yet, or at least not in North America. To my right is the GAC GS4 Compact Sport Utility Vehicle. It is the first compact sport utility vehicle by GAC, which is a Chinese automaker from Guangzhou, China. It's the first of its kind to be shown here in North America. GAC is the first and only Chinese company to show in Detroit. The last time they were here was about 2 years ago, and at that point it was their very first press conference here at Kobo. We're standing outside of the traditional media area inside Kobo Hall, but it doesn't mean anything about the size of the company. GAC sold over 1 million vehicles last year in China and the markets where the company is active. What you have here is a vehicle that could very well be seen on North American roads by 2017 when GAC is anticipating a North American launch. What do we know about it? It has turbocharged engines, 1.3 and 1.5 liter. It has a 7-speed dual clutch transmission. The same things that we find in compact SUVs now. So the question really is when we're going to see this car.
Thank you for joining us at the Detroit Auto Show. Please like and leave a comment below. We'll be back with more auto show coverage mid-February from Chicago.